In this tutorial, you'll learn how to perfectly remove the green screen from any video in DaVinci Resolve. Let's get started. Once inside DaVinci Resolve with your video clip ready, before starting to remove the green screen, it's advisable to differentiate the green background from the person as much as possible. Right now, this video has a gray tone and the colors can barely be differentiated. Doing this will make the final result much better. We select the video clip and go to the color module. Here, we can slightly increase the contrast by adjusting the curves. But mainly, the adjustment I recommend increasing is the saturation of the green color. This will help make the green screen color much easier to remove. To increase the saturation of just the green color, we need to go to the Hue versus Saturation menu. Perfect. Now, on this graph, we will increase the value of the green color. To be able to separate the different colors, we can click on these small circles below. Now, we simply click on this circle in the green area and raise its position to increase the saturation of just the green color. And by doing this, we will have made the green background color much more intense. Now the chroma and the person are much more differentiated. Important: if your video also contains other green elements, like the apple in this video, don't worry. In this tutorial, I'll also teach you how to keep the green elements and not disappear when removing the green screen. Once this is done, we return to the DaVinci Resolve editing module. We select our video clip, right-click, and look for the option to create fusion clip. Then we go to the fusion module by clicking on the magic wand icon. Perfect. Once inside the fusion module, we'll add a tool to remove the green screen color. We press the keyboard shortcut shift space to open the tool finder. Now we must search for the tool Delta Keyer. Here it is. We select Delta Composer and click on Add. Make sure the Delta Keyer node is correctly connected with these two yellow lines. Now we select the Delta Keyer node and go to the menu of Inspector, located at the top right. Here we will find all the options of the Delta Keyer. Removing the green screen color is very easy. We simply click on the selector icon, hold it down, and drag it over the green color of the video. Perfect. At first glance, it seems that we've already correctly removed the green screen from our video. If you think so, you might be wrong. Most likely there are errors, but don't worry. It's nothing we cannot easily fix. If we change the view mode from final result to matte, we can more clearly observe the areas where there are faults. The white area is what we want to keep, and the black area is what we want to eliminate. The background must be completely black. If there are gray areas, it means that there are still artifacts of the green screen. To fix this, go to the Matte menu. Here you will find a bar called Threshold that will allow you to adjust the white and black areas. We click on the left circle and adjust the bar until there are no gray areas in the background and it's completely black. And then we do the same with the right area. We click on the right circle and adjust the white area with the selection of the woman so that there are no gray areas. Remember that there is a part of the video where a green apple appears, the same color as the chroma. Therefore, that area will indeed be gray. But don't worry, because as I mentioned earlier, in case there are green objects in your video, I'll teach you how to preserve them. Once we've finished with the video selection and the areas are completely white and black, we can now activate the final result mode and be able to see our video again. Lastly, for the chroma to be completely professional, it's advisable to apply a little blur on the edges so that they're not so harsh, but just a very little. Increasing the blur value to 0.0005 is enough. Great. We would have our chroma finished. If your video also has green elements, Now I'll teach you how to easily recover them. To preserve an element of the same color as the chroma, it's necessary to create a mask that selects that element. This way, we can make the Delta Keyer effect not affect the green apple and keep it in our video. To create a mask, we have to click on the mask icons. They can be rectangular, ellipse, or we can also create a mask with the shape we want using the polygon or B-spline. By clicking on a mask, the background with the green screen will reappear, but don't worry, it's totally normal. Now, we simply make left clicks on the viewer and create a mask that contains the green apple inside. Make sure to make it large enough so in case the apple moves a little, the mask covers it throughout the video. Okay, we have finished making the mask, but the apple is still not green and we still have the green background. We want the opposite, to eliminate the green background and make the apple keep its original green color. For this, we invert the mask by clicking on the box of invert. Great, we now have our video with the chroma removed and preserving a green element. If we return to the editing module, we can see that we indeed have our video without background. To add any background to our video, we upload our video clip to an upper video track on video track 2. In the media panel, we search for the background we want to add, and we drag it right below the chroma video clip. And now we would have our chroma video with the background we want. I hope this tutorial has been useful to you. In case you want to export the video without the background, here I leave you a tutorial in which I explain how to do it. See you in the next video.